people that have organised today, have they done a decent job?
Do you feel it came up to expectation?
Yeah. Oh, it's good. It's more than I expected, I think.
Is it?
Never been to a reunion before. You always think of the ones you see on television, which are usually, pretty quiet. I'm pleased with it. There's a lot of people that I had totally forgotten about, which is good to see. And ones that I have got to see have been here. That's been good.
Well, I've got the letter out of Canberra, and I was like, oh shit, what's happening on here? Yeah. I'll be back there about then. I really wanted to go there. Oh, I've had a good time there. Really enjoyed it.
Okay. If you looked at the time intervals, and people said, let's do it again in 5 years, would that be too soon?
No, I'd say about another 10 years. Well, I mean, 10 years it seems to have gone so quick, so 5 years may seem soon, but you see how much people change, it may not.
Some people are saying, even 10 years down the track so far has been too early because they're still, most of them, they're still finding themselves. Some are still university students, others are between jobs and the like. They really haven't settled in. Alright, so you reckon probably minimum of 10 years? Because there's enough change in that time.
I know I enjoyed tonight, so I'd like to do it again. But
perhaps there's a roll on.
Yes.
And you get close to each other, you can maybe 5 years you'd like to do it
again. Yeah, yeah. It's hard to say. But I think you're right, 10 years is when you see the change.
Yeah. Well, do you agree that David Selwyn's the big change, you know?
Well, no, he shitted him.
Is he?
Yeah, he was shitting him, yeah. I've seen David Selwyn about 4 years ago before I left. He changed a lot then. I thought, he's there, you know, he's on here. What's he doing tonight? Oh, no. He's not really stupid.
Has he? Off the rails.
Yeah, it is pretty well.
Yeah. Buying himself, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thanks for being part of the video, Jets. And did that hurt, Al?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Well, bloody hell.
No words.
It's not any sort of. No visible.
Ask the questions away. It's easy, eh? Where have you been the last 10 years?
Where have I been for the last 10 years?
What have you been up to?
I work at Promotion Farm. I've been there for about 9 years. I'm married. I married Glenn Poole. We bought a house in Colabar.
Sorry, I'm just waiting for sort of. Yes, got a house in Colabar, don't you?
No, we have no children at the moment.
Okay.
Maybe in the future.
How long in the future? Can I ask that?
About 2 years. Right. So you're going to be sooner than this.
Oh, we've had magic calls.
Okay. Listen, is it true that you were one of those ropeable type students when you were here, like the worst, the pits type student?
Oh yes, but I think teachers had a lot to do with that.
Oh, you're still playing here, so?
Not all the teachers.
Yeah.
Just some of the teachers.
Who in particular?
Mr. Kavanagh.
Yeah. Why Mr. Kavanagh?
Because he was the sort of teacher that would jump in the cot with him and fail.
Pedophile, jumping pots with children.
That's called a pedophile.
Never mind, you learned something, right? Okay, this is a hinge file. Alright, any other teachers? What,
Mr. McIntyre.
He rubbed you up the wrong way?
Yes, jammed my nose up against the blackboard and told me to stick it there.
Yeah.
I told him where the stick is.
Standard practice for most teachers.
Subjects that I've done on the teachers.
Yeah, but you chose. You chose the subjects, huh?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. Okay.
It was education.
No choice. Okay. We'll move along. And we're talking to?
Debbie Cool. I'm married. I have 2 children. I have a house at Yarraville. And I've been working on an awful mushroom farm.
Hello, the Mushroom Farm Connection.
Yeah. Now I've been working side by side with Lorraine.
Yeah? Right. Okay.
I can't think of anything else. She's got two kids. I said that.
Oh, and she lives at Yarrambool. Okay, so you're all at that neck of the woods. Like out the other side of Mittagong.
Yes.
You've always been in the town? You haven't gone anywhere else?
No.
Oh, okay. We got all right.
Now I've done office work and then I've done work in hospital and got married and had two kids.
Do they turn out boys and girls or
two girls?
Happy with girls or? They're a lot easier than boys in ways.
I don't know, I've got boys.
Oh, you've got a mix of them. Well, girls, how have you found tonight? Have you enjoyed tonight?
Yes, I've
enjoyed it really.
It was an experience walking through the school again.
You reckon that was a good part?
Yes, I reckon
that was good.
Yeah. I mean, it was a terrible disaster.
Why?
Who was leading the thing with themselves? Didn't
matter, anybody.
Right? All right. What came back as you went through the school? Just...
Memories of the corridor.
Yeah. Screaming up and down the stairwell.
Room to room. Where you used to stick your bag, and I used to always forget where I was stuck my bag.
It was interesting. I think that was the highlight of the night.
Yeah, just doing that walk.
Yeah, just going on that walk, just bringing back lots of memories.
Well, do you reckon this was a good venue? Like it was better to be here than say a place like the bowling club or whatever. Okay, well, that's all I want to ask unless you want to say something to the organisers. You got anything to say to the organisers?
Yes, organise another one just as good in 5 years.
5 years.
Okay.
You reckon it'll take another 2 years to play?
I reckon another 10 years.
Well, I'll be watching this video, and I'll know people say five, but by 10, you know, 10 minutes. Okay.
Would have been good though if all had it turned up.
Yeah.
Like some of the locals that we spoke to, when we asked them to come, they just turned around and said, no, what's school done for us? Yeah. It wasn't a school thing, it was something. I mean, there's a lot of places out there, even though they're still a bit lonely, we haven't seen for probably since we left school.
Yeah.
And it was just great to see them again.
Okay, someone knocking at the door, so we'll take that as our cue. Thanks very much for talking to us. Fitzgerald? Me? Fitzgerald or Barry?
Yeah, now? Yeah.
Still?
Still married. Happily. Living 3 years.
Okay. Straightening out that Robert Decker.
Yeah. Okay. Robert Decker. Goodness me.
Listen, we can say it. Let's reveal it now, okay? We all know how sordid Robert was in his upbringing. And always turn into it.
No one knows the real Robert except me.
Yeah, he's turned into the mild man.
Robert Decker, accountant.
Accountant!
Yes, can you believe it? Robert Decker, accountant.
And the great smuggler in the back of the school turns into a straight-laced cooker. And he was afraid to come on video.
Huh?
Yeah, he was afraid to come on video to admit that.
Yeah, he wouldn't join me.
See, we've got left him an empty chair. That's where you would have been,
it
Robert.
It should be Robert.
Yeah.
But it's just Irene.
It's okay.
Sorry. It's just Irene.
All right.
Yeah.
Now listen, Irene, this is a special night for you, isn't it?
It's wonderful. It's fabulous seeing everyone here again.
Right.
The big buzz actually has been to be able to have it in the school hall. When it was first mentioned, I was a bit sort of sceptical about it. I didn't know how people would feel. But it's great to finally have our own school hall, something that we've worked on for years and years. I don't know whether people remember, but in year 12, when I was editing the school newspaper, I wrote an article and it was sort of whatever happened to our school hall. We'd raised a lot of money and we just never had raised enough for the school hall, and there was a lot of sort of skeptical things happening at the time. And to come back here and to be able to use the school hall, it's a real thrill for me.
Right.
And I'm sure for sort of Donna and Dorothy and some of the others that have been helping with the reunion committee. Yeah.
Actually, I think you guys have been a lot better organised than the last 1979 year team.
Really?
Or just in the school. Because you've had a bigger load of shoulders around the place. I don't know, how's it been working with the rest of the committee?
Actually, it was really great. Like, Donna and Dodd especially, and probably, like, and Joan and Liz, I've known for years and years, but to finally sort of come together and be working on something, and something that we were all looking forward to sort of see the end product, it was really good. And, I don't know, I probably was a bit sceptical of how it would all turn out with sort of egos and different clashes, but it's been good. Actually, I was saying to Donna and Dodd, it'd be great to sort of carry it through. It'd be nice to sort of see a follow-on and keep the contact and not just leave it at sort of a year 10 reunion, but to sort of carry it through and keep up the contact.
What sort of thoughts do you have in mind?
Well, probably just a few get-togethers, maybe down the local pub. I mean, we all like our sort of odd drink, as you can see.
Yes, cleansing our hands. Right. How soon do you think a massive reunion like this should take place?
Actually, 10 years has probably been a good guide, but I don't know, the next one, maybe, it might be a bit longer, sort of 15, 20, I don't know. Depending how we feel, especially if Donna and Doc and I can sort of keep in contact, you never know, it might be sort of the next 10 years, or 15, 20, I don't know. But to see, we've had probably 50% roll-up, so we've been really happy with that.
Where did the idea come from? Who's inspiration?
Over 12 months ago, we were down in the local pub, but it was kind of saying, you know, it's nearly 10 years on, so he said it's about time we thought about the reunion. So a few of us started talking about it, but it wasn't probably until the last 8 months or so that we actually got together.
Now, who was that, Roberta? Roberta or?
Roberta sort of probably wasn't so keen on the organising part of it, but he was keen to give a hand. But it was more a female orientated thing, so Joan rang me and I thought Donna and Dorothy were organising something, and we thought, well, it's time to bring everyone, and so it ended up sort of being more or less 5 minutes, and we went from there.
Well, let me compliment you. I think the majority of the comments that we've heard tonight have been positive. So that says something for, you know, you can't please all of the people all the time.
No, that's the problem.
Let's face it, you've pleased about 90% of them, and that's not bad for the course.
Thanks, Dennis. Yeah, we were trying to sort of work on the easiest way sort of possible for everyone to have a good night and enjoy it from there, but I don't know. We've had a good time, as you can see. We've sort of made the most of it, especially let our hair hang loose. Once we got here, but I'm hoping most of the people enjoyed sort of seeing sort of everyone, especially some that they hadn't seen for 10 years or so. It was a real buzz.
And how many people came from out of the way?
We had Leanne and Rodney that came over from Tassie. That was great. We didn't have them sort of come till a bit later. We wanted to make sure we had enough to make it worth their while. We had a couple from Queensland, some from Canberra, a lot from Sydney. There were quite a few locals, but that was disappointing because there was at least 20 or 30 probably that were locals and probably could have made the effort and didn't turn up, so that was disappointing, yeah. But they've sort of come from all distances and we're really happy to see them.
Okay. Well, congratulations on that job well done.
Thank you.
Good party, eh? Now, this fellow doesn't really represent a Year 10 1980 student. In fact, he's a 1981 Year 10. Okay? But we thought we'd just have a look at what it was to be a person beneath a form as great and as mighty as 1980. Impressions?
Yeah, well, actually, being a year below this current Year 10, I always thought that we were basically superior to them.
Oh.
And we looked at them as losers. Right. They were, really. I mean, you know, when you've got people like Carol Marsh in the front.
Oh, yeah.
And Julie Hocking.
Yeah.
And Robbie Becker.
You can only pity them.
Yeah, we felt sorry for them, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they couldn't even, they couldn't do anything, really, could they? They couldn't, what couldn't they do?
They really left no impact or impression on the school.
No, they didn't even plant a tree. Planted a tree, they didn't even plant a tree.
And here they are, 10 years later, coming back to school.
10 years later, they came back. I think they gave a rock to the school, and the rock doesn't even grow.
Absolutely. I think the rock is just outside of Adelock, isn't it?
That's right, a rock. You know, if you young students come and have a look at the rock, that's where it is. Yep. Yeah. But they were losers. And that's what it's true. And they still lose. If you were here tonight, you'd see that still lose.
Well, we've been watching them.
Yes.
They go past.
Yeah.
You're calling them losers.
Yeah.
I don't think your life's going to be worth living
after this year. No, if they see it, then. I don't know where I live, so it's all right, really.
Yeah. Go with the tumble with a fall. What's the expression? Go with a fall, go with a punch.
Go with a punch. Fly with a punch or something? Oh, no.
Whatever.
Go with a fly or something like that.
What are we about here?
Yeah.
This is getting late, mate. This time it is 1:30.
Well, I wouldn't normally be here, but my sister, who was in this form, such a loser, I had to come back and pick her up.
Right.
Because she's 26 years old now, she's still taking her home by herself.
Right. And there is the random breath.
I'm not driving. I'm just a passenger.
In fact, I noticed you're drinking something there, mate.
Yeah, lemonade. Well, I would advise all young students if they get a chance to drink anything, lemonade's a go. It's good for you. Yeah. Isn't it sugar high? It's better than alcohol, really.
Do you want me to send this to Shelley's as a promo?
Yeah. Shelley's is the best.
It's our state drink.
Sprite's not bad. That's the Victoria state drink, for that matter, actually. You've got Victoria and see the commercials.
Right.
Yeah. And Queensland. Good stuff.
Okay. How much of this reunion did you see then?
How much what?
How much of the reunion?
Well, I was actually a dorm at the reunion because the school sort of stigmatised, they need to have security there. Roy left after 2 hours. Yes. I came back 3 hours later. So I've seen quite a bit. And it was sad. It was sad. Yeah, that's all I can say. Okay. That's the way I sum it up as sad.
Right.
Anything else?
Who would you like?
The form in general, probably, their combined IQ was about 120.
Right.
Yeah, 120.
That was about how many students?
100.
Yeah.
That's about 1.2 per student. It's not good. Now, they'd all be room 9ers if they're back in the Barrow High. Or IMs, I suppose.
That's
long
terminology.
IMs these days. Yeah, they're all the IMs. Yeah, that's not their fault. Yeah, their parents, I think.
Okay. So you've been a really sober influence on tonight.
Yeah, I've told the truth.
I mean, most people have been hiding the truth. Yep. The whole floor, mate, is you're a dead of
I haven't told any lies.
No lies. And you don't even look like Darren Nash.
No, I've got a beard. I would have one, but I can't grow one, actually.
Okay, mate. Well, I think I'll leave you at this point.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks for having those. Well, just the bravery.
Thank you.
To speak honest.
Thank you.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yes. Again, the Holy Trinity, or should we call you the Unholy Trinity? Actually, guys, we're just going to zero in on this guy because Unmasked.
This is the Phantom. Unmasked.
Okay.
1980, look in your programs and see the Phantom.
The Phantom. Okay. Right out. That'll be a buzz for somebody. I'm not sure who.
Anybody who knows history.
Okay. Right, guys, what do you think of the night? How's it going?
It's been a good
great night.
Yeah. It's amazing how many people have turned up.
Especially like the belly dancer.
And then the strip telegram coming in, that was
great. Yeah, that's right. But the wet t-shirt competition was a bit late now.
Oh, yeah. Well, especially the boys doing it. when we work on the principle of something out of tonight, what parts were the goers? What parts were memorable?
There was a lot of good people there. We all had a good time.
Right. Make the night.
A bit dismal, it didn't have more information about this year, actually.
Right.
We'd like to know what's going on in Barrow High School now.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Like,
really?
All the chairs are chained to the trees.
All right.
There's no grass anymore.
Yeah. Right. Well, when you were here at school...
Is that all microeconomic reform or something?
No, it's called just straight out population growth. 700 when you were here, the place was comfortable. Now we're approaching 1,000, and really the physical size of the place hasn't changed. You just got to squash more people into a smaller area. And just like rats in a nest, something's got to give. So those chairs have got to be chained because they end up being wrecked. Most of those chairs you had on the stage are only about a year old. All the others just die, perish.
There's not many of them, though. There's
no, not, because most of them are just ruined, just out of use, or abuse. Yes. Gentlemen, what thing makes year 10, 1980? Now, look, just before you, I had, who was it in here? Jeff Marsh was in here. Running your form down as lowlife. Losers.
They were low life.
Yeah?
They didn't know what real life was like, did they, Jerry?
Okay. Well, redeem yourselves. I mean, he said that you have a corporate intelligence of 120. That makes it about 1.2 each.
Oh, dear.
I mean, does this smack of truth?
Jeff Marsh was bouncer at the door, whereas we're executives going out on a good night.
Yeah. Right. That says it all.
Yeah.
So do you listen to the bellboy or the guy that's got the money for the executive suite?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. You guys got any memories that go back? I mean, has anything been talked about tonight that was just out of mind until you got here? And just mixing with people that's come back?
Heaps of things you just don't even think about.
Yeah.
Somebody obviously thinks, well, that's an important memory, and they bring it up, and you think, yeah, that was great. You think about it.
How many of you would be disappointed with the roll-up of staff? Do you think more staff should be?
Helen Chambers was a pretty notable absence.
Well, Helen, just to put you in the picture, Helen, do you realise, went overseas to do some exchange teaching to England, found herself a husband, came back to teach, and he followed her, and she's gone back to live in England now.
Well, like up Fort Queensland.
Yeah.
That's not much further.
That's smart. You drove.
That's right, she would have flown.
Oh, well, that's. I think she'll enjoy hearing this if she ever sees it again.
Yeah.
I mean, she may one day in her life get back to Australia and come to a reunion.
It's changed lots since we were here.
Yeah, tell me.
You'll have to take over a few more acres if you want to be here in the year 2000, the way it's going.
We'll just keep going up. A bit like New York.
There's a lot more mountains now than when we were here.
Yeah, there's a lot more buildings than when we were here.
Yeah, that's the buildings. Yeah. It's a big difference.
When you went back into the old buildings, did things come back?
Shame.
The smell.
It smells like
that. It's not the same.
The bathroom.
The plastic bags.
The bathroom.
Yeah, they're the same.
Still the same.
Yeah. Okay. We've got one of the committee here, so we're talking to
executives here.
How would we change this, or do you think we've hit on the right recipe for a reunion?
Yeah, it was good. I think the music's good now, so we could talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, the keeping touch is
you want to be able to talk more. That's the music's all drowned out. Because you're on a table, and people move around between tables to their old friends.
Yeah.
You want to be able to talk more, so be quiet on music.
So work on the principle of giving more fluid time.
Yeah, you can disco and go out and dance and meet people anytime.
Yeah.
But you can't really get to get them talking that much.
Well, I think there's a time of thawing out because you've had 10 years of sort of going insular. And you've really got to break that down again, don't you?
I don't know. A lot of us just sort of fall back in, really.
Most people were still, most of the time,
you wouldn't even know we left. Yeah. You'd never know we left. Getting
here. Faithful.
Jennings. Michael's wife.
Yeah. Michael's wife.
Okay.
You wouldn't know that. I mean, this is the fourth guy she's been sitting on.
Yeah.
I mean, I caught her, Michael, I don't know if you want to hear this, but
on this tape, I've got her in a very compromising position. We're the next Chevite. Can you believe that? I'd like to put it together.
So can I get a copy of this video?
Is this what's going on? Yeah, listen, you can get this video, let me say. Let me do an advert for you. You can just simply mail the school a tape with your name on it.
Well, I have a sister who's 10 years younger than me, exactly. Right. And she's in year 10 now.
You give her the tape.
High school.
Yeah. Right. It's weird. She's just finished her year 10.
Right.
I come back from my year 10 high school reunion.
Yeah, well, she'll have a tape
she'll
of her form.
Yeah,
she
she'll be getting one.
Did the form last weekend.
I thought, because a lot of people
Nah, 10 years.
10 years?
We have lost a few people in the last 10 years.
Yeah.
Like Roy Hearn. And,
yeah. Although it's only been, what, two?
And Mr. McGraw. Yeah. Mr. McGraw.
Yeah.
McGraw.
Yeah.
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 Mr. McGraw's here for quite a while.
Well, I'll tell you when to change legs.
All right, well, let's work on the principle that we would do it in the year 2000.
Yeah.
Yes.
And would you like it here? Would you do it here?
Oh, yes. Yeah, you'd have to do it back in school, yes.
Yeah. And another romp through the buildings, whatever.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was a highlight. The highlight was it was a highlight going through the buildings.
Actually, I've seen what year 10 was like, what year 10 was like now.
You want a tour through the Demountables?
No. Actually, it would be pretty boring there.
Maybe you'd get a year 10 to come in at the same time that we're having our reunion even.
Yeah.
What, and combine you fellas with the present year 10?
Yeah, we're having a video and stuff.
Yeah, we'd like to know what the year 10s are doing,
I'm sure the subjects have changed a lot. What they do at school.
Well, actually, they have. Yeah, a lot of dance and performance has come into it.
Yeah.
I noticed that today when we were setting up. There was a few girls that.
Yeah, Jamila Martinek. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
So we see trouble smoking. I think they smoke nowadays, don't they?
Smoking
schools nowadays?
No, it's a drug-free zone.
Yes.
It's a drug-free zone. In Queensland, they're allowed to smoke if they've got permission from their parents and they're over 16.
Right.
Smoking areas, make them smoke.
It's a challenge.
Now listen, Rob, I don't know what this is, mate, but I've been trying all night to get you to speak on this, and now we're going to get you to shut up. I said, what do you reckon, fellas? What do we do to a guy like Rob, who pretends he's not really motivated?
He's a natural performer. That's what it is.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah, I agree.
Well, listen, Rob, I'd like to say on behalf of 1, 2, 3 others, could you convey to the rest of the committee our thanks for what they've done tonight?
Well, I'd like to say thanks for letting us have the premises to have our reunion. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to say hello to all the teachers that haven't been able to come here tonight.
Right.
I haven't been one of the sort of persons that used to get on with a lot of the teachers that were at the school, because I was always a bit of a
it's a bit like a game of football. When you're at school, the two teams, it's us and them.
Yeah, that's
and then
right.
You come off the field and you say, well, hang on, that was a game, it wasn't a bad game, good on you. And you actually learn, I suppose, out of it, but you're...
I'm sure everybody here tonight would say thanks to the committee, because this has been great.
Yeah.
It's been good.
It has been good. The committee's really done it well.
Yeah.
The effort they put in, the contact everybody.
That's going to be the biggest thing, just getting people's names.
Well, like Michael's in Queensland.
Yeah.
Rod out there, he's from here, from Tasmania.
Right.
My
nephew.
Yeah. Made a real effort.
Yeah.
Three kids out from Queensland, that's it,
That's bigger. Well, thanks for your time, fellas, and thanks for
being
part of the video that will go out to
history.
How do you get a copy?
Brett, do you want to just give us a resume of where you've been and what you've been up to in 10 years?
I made a huge mistake. I joined the Air Force. I spent 2.5 years at Wagga undergoing trade training. I was 17 and a half when I left. I spent 4 years in Queensland working on F-11s, and I got posted to fire squadron in Canberra, working on RAF helicopters for the last 3 years, and it took me 8.5 years to get out of the Air Force. It was probably one of the biggest mistakes I've ever made.
So after a year, you knew you made a mistake?
after 3 months I knew I'd made a mistake.
Yeah. But you signed yourself up for that time? Or
yeah.
So you were stuck?
I enlisted for 9 years. So yeah. After a 90-day probation period, I told him I'd realised I'd made a mistake and I wasn't happy with what I was doing. But it's pretty easy to influence a 15-year-old kid who's sort of away from home. And I ended up staying. And I've sort of been recovering from that ever since. But yeah, things are looking pretty good now.
Right. Where are you now?
Still in Canberra. Yeah. I live in Canberra. And I got a job with the ACT government to pick up my long service leave. Mm-hmm. So I can carry that straight over from the 9 year service with the RAT.
That's good.
And I got a part-time job in the nightclub in Canberra. Mm-hmm. It's interesting.
Is it?
Yeah.
You don't want to go into details on this. Was it just a bouncer?
A lot of people that are embarrassed about being a doorman, but I don't mind. Yeah. It's good. It's a good way to meet people. It's a good way to learn to react to people.
Yeah.
And just how to associate.
Yeah.
It's interesting. I enjoy it.
Yeah.
And I'm a pacifist.
Are you?
Yeah.
Deep down.
Yeah.
As you bodily remove people, you keep telling them I'm a pacifist.
Yeah. I don't go there to hurt people. I mean, some guys do, but
yeah. You're not a Rambo then.
Oh no. Definitely not.
Well, you were just reflecting about what was it you were saying? The way the form has sort of gone with the four corners of the world and a night like tonight is just a real buzz and a score of getting back to relationships that we've been
in. I mean, it's nostalgia is incredible. And so many people have come so close to me, but you sort of didn't ever think they'd be there. So, I mean, obviously I never came into contact with them. Like, three other fellows that I've met tonight have been in the Air Force, but I didn't know they were. I didn't know where they were or what they were doing. And I mean, it happens. It's one of those things. It's something that shouldn't. Like, I mean, I keep in contact with a sort of, like a couple of the people that I was pretty close to.
Yeah.
But, I mean, as for the rest, well, you only see them once every 10 years, I guess.
Well, just on that score, how often do you reckon reunions like this ought to happen? Better a 5 year period, or is 10 years a good time? Sort of?
Oh no, 10 years is too long.
Yeah.
People grow and people change, it happens so fast. And I mean, I had trouble recognising a lot of people.
Yeah. Well, do you reckon David Sell deserved the award that he took of most change? Or?
No, I don't think Sell has changed that much.
Right.
I mean, I've
surface-wise, maybe, but
yeah, to look at him, he has. I mean, he grew the hair, and, but he was always sort of. He always wanted to be a bit different than the average person, and I mean, it's just a combination of fashion and looks. He's always been pretty self-conscious like that.
Yeah.
He hasn't changed at all.
Yeah.
I don't think. I mean,
who were the big changes then? Have you met someone that you just blew you away?
Or? Well. Saul.
Saul Burgess? Really?
Yeah.
What's happening there?
Oh. In himself, he's changed so much. He went through so much trouble.
Yeah.
And he's just settled down so much. Wow. I mean, I see Saul every couple of months. I mean, we ring each other pretty regularly.
Right.
And I mean, to know somebody like that, to know what they've been through.
Yeah.
Hello.
It's only me.
Yeah.
We just want our money.
You can't have it.
You want to tell us, Irene, about this gang bashing in the corridors?
Gang bashing? No, I was no part of that.
Irene used to beat me up.
Always. You're already telling stories.
So, Aaron, you
it's
actually
not true.
Brett,
it's not true.
Definitely
not true.
Yeah.
You did. Do you want to turn history lessons in the back of the history books? I can show you to prove it.
Sit down, there's a chair there.
Come on, Don, join us. Come on, join us.
I hope you're not that inebriated that you're not going to remember the punchline.
Yeah, it's a bit like that.
Okay. What is this about the history lessons in the back of the history book?
Irene knows more than I do.
What? Pass the buck.
Cop out.
I'm pleading ignorance.
I think it's all
right. Brett pleads ignorance.
Yes.
I got it right that time. No, really, I did.
That's a mouthful.
Right. Give me a break.
She still has the hockey ball in her mouth.
But let me say this. Play hockey, but anyway.
That was a volleyball.
The history lesson was the place to be.
I was a volleyball.
Because that was a place that you knew what was going on.
Well, I was too small.
Yeah. Brett used to write notes in the back of his history books and pass them forward. And I used to write notes back and then pass them back to him again.
Ah.
So he used to sit in the back row and we sit in the second back row and I sit there.
Was that Carly?
Yeah.
Mine.
Carly, is this Carly's history lesson?
No,
Miss McClure.
Yes.
Carly
never
and Carly is a ring-in for Robin Williams.
You reckon?
Did you see Dead Poets Society?
Yeah.
Oh, he was fabulous. Yeah. Ring-in for Carly. Yep. Sorry.
Okay.
Okay.
Now that we've got that out of the way. Okay.
Oh,
so
yeah,
can you finish there?
Never.
With your story?
Dorothy, have we got enough money?
Okay.
Come on.
Listen, let me, Irene, just on this score.
Right.
Okay. How exactly were you gang bashing, Brett?
Gang bashing?
How? How did you get away with it?
Easy.
He was such a wimp, see? He looked like this.
I was a lot smaller than Irene.
Right.
I'm leaving.
Throw me up against the wall and beat the shit out of me.
Yeah.
Outside the
art class, actually. It's total honesty there. Okay. Right, well, what are we going to say, Brett? I mean, we've had this interview.
I've been exposed.
I've had my turn. So,
I bet you've never heard of a bouncer being beaten up by a woman.
No, well, that's it, mate. I hope no one in Canberra's watching this.
I hope they see it, actually.
Well, listen, Brett, I think you're going to be the last person on our tape, so do you want to say anything to the people in the future?
I'd just like to say try not to make a mistake.
How cool we are.
And if you do, learn to live with it and be comfortable and be happy. Because that's the best you can do.
Okay. All right, well, we're just going to do a quick pan on the last few folk that are here. Madonna, what do you want to say?
Ditto.
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 Oh,
ditto.
I've never had originals.
I think that Brett has got it on the spot.
Has he?
Don't make a mistake.
Yet. Don't make a mistake first off. Mr.
Green. I think Brett's a hunk. But,
that's a problem.
Hey, it's
not
like that.
Opposite. Okay. What's this opposite business? Give us the Latin interpretation.
You know.
Exactly.
Yeah, we understand.
We understand
and we don't believe it.
Right, well, this is the end. You want to sing a final farewell?
Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday.